Thank you for inviting me. I'm happy to present a talk at the Armenian conference. I will speak about very recent results that we obtained together with professors Zhu from Albany, USA, and Samko, Stefan Samko, from Portugal. Well, this is very recent result. We just started the subject, so I may not have answers on all questions, but I'll try. Okay. So we introduced so-called Hausdorff-Berezin operators. We introduced and studied so-called Hausdorff-Berezin operators, but before I give definition, I'll speak a few words about the inspiration of the study. The study was inspired by several theories connected in a sense, theory of so-called operators with homogeneous kernels and so-called Hausdorff operators. Well, little bit of history. One-dimensional case. In one-dimensional case, operator with homogeneous kernel, say KF at point X, is an integral operator with some kernel kxt f of t dt. You can rewrite this operator in so-called Hausdorff form as integral from 0 to infinity, some kernel L of y fxy dy. So I'll call this form, well, people usually call this form Hausdorff. And this operator is an operator with homogeneous kernel if the kernel K satisfies the following properties, K lambda x lambda t equals to lambda minus 1 K x of t. So this operator with homogeneous kernel. So the study of such type of operator goes back to famous theory of Hardy, Littlewood, Polya, and there are many references in this book, there are many papers on such type of operators. Well, in the one-dimensional case, these are the same. I mean, you can rewrite one as another. So Hausdorff operator or operator with one-dimensional homogeneous kernel is the same. Of course, you can reduce it to convolution operator. You can reduce it to convolution operator by just exponential change of variable. So in essence, it will be the same as convolution. This operator can be considered as counterparts of convolutions, being invariant with respect to dilation, and convolutions are invariant with respect to translation. But in a sense, this all is the same, roughly speaking. The situation is changed when you consider multidimensional case. Multidimensional case greater than one. Speaking about operator with homogeneous kernel, we asked for the following property, lambda t lambda x equals to lambda to the power minus n k lambda k x and t in variance with dilation up to some power and rotation invariance k omega t. Well, I write x t here, I write t x, maybe I write here correctly x t, yes, omega x omega t equals to kxt. So these are two conditions. In this case, people say that we consider operators with homogeneous kernel of degree of homogeneity minus n. And Hausdorff operators in this case are quite different operators. Well, not quite, but different. Integral, say, over Rn, a kernel, L of y, function at the point x, apply it to matrix AY, dy, where A is a n by n matrix, which depends on y. So this will be Hausdorff form. Still, these operators have some similarities, but in general, these operators are already different. Well, for the literature, speaking about operators is homogeneous kernels. I refer to the book by Karapetyants and S. Samko, published in 1988 in Russian and 2001 in English. And speaking about Hausdorff operators, I would refer to a paper by Liefland and Moritz, appeared in 2000. Also, there is a paper by, let me see, Chen, Fan, and Wong appeared recently in 2014. But I think if you take a look with this Hausdorff words in Google, you can find several papers and sources. Okay, so this would be some kind of historical remarks. And its inspiration comes from this idea of having invariants. You can just have operator here, you can put it here. So this would be our inspiration. And we wanted to do this similar in a framework of complex variable. And we introduce the operator that I will call KFZ. We are starting, let just D be the unit disk and Z be element of D. I usually write ZX plus EY. Lebesgue measure would be 1 over p dx dy. So this would be standard notations. Operator k f at the point z is nothing but integral over d k of w f alpha z of w dh of w, or integral over d k alpha z of w f of w dh of w. So what does it mean alpha z of w? Alpha z of w is nothing but Möbius transform z minus w, 1 minus z bar w, and dh at the point z is a Haar measure. dA of z, Lebesgue measure, divided by 1 minus z squared. This measure is Möbius invariant, that's why you can put this rotation here, we can put it in the kernel. So this, we take just this idea. We thought for a while what to do. We played with some translations, but we ended up with such type of definition. So this operator, we will call Hausdorff-Berezin operator. Why Hausdorff? It's understandable. Why Berezin? I have examples. Example one, Berezin transform. If you take kernel K to be 1 minus W squared, then this operator is nothing but Berezin transform. BF of Z equals to integral over D, F alpha Z of W, well-known Berezin transform with plain Lebesgue measure. Okay, it's easy to calculate. So Berezin transform gives us the first example of this operator. And in some sense, we think that we have generalization of Hausdorff operator, in the same time we have generalization of Berezin transform. You know that Berezin transform is very important. Complex analysis plays the same role, similar role as Poisson transform. Many, many important features provides for study of functional spaces, operator theory, compactness, etc. Second example I can give you would be averages. Average, say, M epsilon f at the point z equals to 1 over e z epsilon, measure of e z epsilon, integral over e z epsilon, f of w dh w. E z epsilon is a disk in the pseudo-hyperbolic Berman metric. in the pseudo-hyperbolic given by the modulus of Möbius transform. Okay, and this would be the measure with respect to Haar measure, or this disk with respect to Haar measure. So you can rewrite this, you can easily rewrite this as integral over D, characteristic function 0 epsilon over modulus of E0 epsilon at the point W, of course, F alpha Z of W, DH of W. Such operators, such averages, very important also in analysis. For instance, Matilievich and Pavlovich studied these averages with respect to boundedness and proving Forelli-Rudin theorem for p between 0 and 1. And many, many other features they managed to do using these operators. And example, third example, I can mention, I will not write it down here, but I'll just mention maximal Bergman projection. We can recover maximum Bergman projection if we take kernel k of w equals to 1 minus z squared. So this kernel will give us maximal. Ah, okay, yeah, sorry. Yeah, w. Yeah. Taking this kernel, we recover maximal, not Bergman, maximal Bergman projection. This is a modulus. This is a modulus. Okay. Okay, so this would be inspiration, examples, and. Well, usually we don't work with such kernels. We usually work with kernels of two variables. And it's a natural question how to rewrite or how to understand if we have operator with kernel depending on two variables, whether or not it can be reduced to Hausdorff form. Of course, we have very simple answer on this question, which also adds some sense to the definition of this operator. So if you consider just for now k f of z given by integral over d, k with tilde z w, f of w, dh of w, then if this kernel of two variable kernel satisfies the invariance k z w, equals to k with tilde 0 alpha z w, then it exactly can be rewrite it in the form of Hausdorff. I will call this, so I will write here exactly Hausdorff-Berezin. So if and only if, this condition, if and only if. Let me call this k, this class q class, q class, class of Hausdorff-Berezin operators. Another condition, more strong condition, if you take Möbius alpha A of Z, alpha A of W, and you get invariance, very strong invariance, KZW, for any A from union disk, if this is valid, then you come to radial. You still have, of course, Hausdorff-Berezin radial kernel. Radial kernel. So your kernel, you'll get such operator with here modulus with radial kernel. Let me call this class Q radial class. So this symmetry conditions provide some understanding on what kind of operators we study. Exactly, we study such type of operators. If you want, if you prefer to have it in two variable kernel form, then you can have it. And with this condition, well, examples, any function depends, depending on the Möbius transform, it's okay for the kernel. Now, very quickly about algebraic properties. Algebraic properties. We have a theorem. Well, first, if operator K belongs to Q class, it's Hausdorff-Berezin. Operator L belongs to QR, it's Hausdorff-Berezin, but with radial kernel. Then composition belongs to Q class. Okay. But actually, this class is more important for studying algebras, and we instinct to study algebras later. I'll have just to mention, I will not go deeper in details, but if you take K and L from Q radial, then you have that KL belongs to Q radial. You have KL equals to LK. And you have that K conjugate belongs to Q radial. So obviously this would be next, maybe next step of study of such operator. I will not mention all properties. These are the most important ones that describe the nature of these operators. Okay? But our main result is about boundedness properties. I probably don't need these examples anymore. To speak about boundedness, well, boundedness in LP with Haar measure. Later I will say that we have some results on with regular measure, but I'll present later. So we have to introduce, as in theory of operators so with homogeneous kernels, we have to introduce some constant. Let K be supremum, Z belongs to D, integral over D, K alpha zeta Z, absolute value, dH of zeta. K1 P sigma is supremum, Z belongs to D, integral over D. Here it comes well-known Berman normalized kernel, K say zeta at the point Z. It's not the same K. Sigma over P, here it comes K at the point zeta, dH of zeta. And last condition, K2 PQ, no, P sigma, excuse me, Q sigma equals to supremum, Z belongs to D, integral over D. Again, Berman normalized kernel, zeta at the point Z, the power sigma over Q. Here, little bit more complicated construction. K minus zeta, 1 minus zeta, Z bar, 1 minus zeta bar, Z, dH. It's not symmetric condition, but if the kernel K is radial, it goes. This is the modulus of this is 1. So if you have radial kernel, you just have the same. 1 over P plus 1 over Q equals to 1. And sigma is a real number. So these are the conditions. And of course, Berman kernel K zeta at the point Z is a normalized Berman kernel, coherent state, 1 minus zeta squared, 1 minus zeta z bar squared. Don't remember zeta bar or z, but okay. So it should be anti-holomorphic in z, no, it should be holomorphic in zeta. It depends how you define the Berman projection. If you put overline, that you write bar here. So, yes, so in this case, we put overline over the kernel. So it's okay. Okay. What is inside of integral should be holomorphic with respect to outer variable. Yeah. So, the theorem says, as you understand, we split two cases, P equals 1 and K less than infinity, then operator, Hausdorff operator is bounded in L1 with measure dH. P between 1 and infinity and both K1 P sigma less than infinity, K2 P sigma less than infinity for some sigma, not for all sigma, for some fixed sigma, then the operator K is bounded in LP with the measure GH over the index, of course. And you can also have estimate for the norm of this operator. Well, this would be sufficient conditions for the boundedness of Hausdorff-Berezin operators. I will not give proof of this theorem, quite technical, but it uses standard technique of analysis, of complex analysis, and also, which is important, we use technique of operators with homogeneous kernels of real analysis. So this kind of mixture of technique of which come from real and complex analysis. Okay, so what about necessity of this condition? We can get necessity for positive kernels. If kernel is positive, and let me don't write, but instead of supremum, we have to write infinum. So if you replace supremum with infinum, then we have theorem which says if K is bounded in LP dH, 1 less or equal P less than infinity, then first P equal 1 means that this K with infinum, I'll write here K infinum less than infinity. Second, 1 less than P bigger than 1 less than infinity. K 1 with infinum P sigma less than infinity. And K2 infinum PQ sigma also less than infinity for all sigma greater than 1. For all sigma, in some sense, it's kind of necessity condition for the boundedness. But of course, for general kernel, we cannot get better. We cannot get better for general kernel, but for a class of very important kernels of such type, K of Z equals to 1 minus Z squared to the alpha. These kernels are very important because, for instance, when alpha equals 2, you have Bresen transform. When alpha equals 1, you come to the maximum Berman projection. So this kernel is very important. In this case, we can give exact conditions. And theorem says that Hausdorff-Berezin operator with such kernel is bounded in LP dH if and only if alpha is strongly bigger than 1 over P, 1 minus 1 over P. And of course, you can see that this coincides with classical theory, because if you take alpha equals to 1, which corresponds to Berman projection, you won't get P equals to 1. It's good news that we don't have anything which contradicts classical theory. Okay, so what about boundedness? I think it's all about boundedness conditions. Let me check. Okay. So what we can do also with these operators? We can raise a question I don't provide with proofs, with sketch of proofs. I don't think that I have much time. But if there will be questions, I will be happy to answer ideas of these proofs. Identity approximation. Well, it's important question in the theory of functions, how to approximate, how to construct some nice identity approximation. If you work with classical spaces, Lebesgue spaces, holomorphic spaces, it's not a big deal. You can construct somehow, inserting like FRZ in the argument, and you're okay for many questions, for many problems. But if you are working with different spaces, like Morris spaces, this kind of approximation does work. So it's important to construct some constructions which will be invariant with respect to kind of rotation, or in our case, Möbius rotation. So actually, if we write this operator, K epsilon f of z equals to integral over d k of w f alpha z epsilon w dh of w. This is not a Hausdorff-Berezin operator. It's not written in the Hausdorff-Berezin form. But we can recover another kernel, I will say k1 epsilon. We can calculate this kernel, change variable, calculate this kernel, such that it will give us exactly Hausdorff-Berezin operator, alpha z w, f of w, dh w. It's very, well, it's not very complicated, but it's quite complicated calculation, so I will not write down it, but it can be found, this kernel. So we can present our approximative operator in the Hausdorff form. And the theorem says that well, we impose standard conditions k of w dh of w equals to 1, and of course k should be in L1. But when you speak about approximations, you usually can handle very nice kernels. It's not a big deal. Theorem says that limit k epsilon f minus f in LP dh equals to 0 when epsilon goes to 0 for all p between 1 and strictly less than infinity. Well, pointwise limit is obvious, and with some calculations we could k epsilon is just definition of this. It's just a definition of this, which can be rewritten in this Hausdorff-Berezin form. This operator is given already in Hausdorff-Berezin form, because it's kind of kernel calculated in the Möbius and f at the point w. I don't present calculations because, well, I don't have much time, I think, but it can be written explicitly, this k1 kernel. Because this is not Hausdorff-Berezin, because you have epsilon inside. Okay, but it can be done. Okay. Well, maybe last question that appeared to us, comparison to the case of regular Lebesgue measure. As I said, of course we can, if you have results for LP dh, you can reformulate results for LP with the plain Lebesgue measure. You have kindly a different kernel, which is given by known formula. You will have a special class of operators, but I will not speak about all general stuff. I'll just mention two cases, two important cases. First case I already mentioned, k of z. If you take 1 minus z squared, then you'll get Berman maximal projection defined by integral over g f w 1 minus z w bar. Here comes modulus dA of dw. In a sense, that boundedness of operator, of Hausdorff-Berezin operator in this space is equivalent to boundedness of this operator with regular measure. We cannot recover boundedness, we cannot recover Berman operator in class of Hausdorff-Berezin operator, but of course we can slightly consider slightly bigger class. For instance, if k, you'll take the same k, k of z 1 minus z squared, and if you multiply this k by a bounded function of this type, y minus z squared w, z bar w squared, 1 minus z bar w modulus. This is a bounded function, as you see, and all boundedness results will be the same. for a new kernel. It will not be a Hausdorff-Berezin operator, but it will possess the same boundedness properties because this function will not affect any boundedness property. So in this case, you can recover regular Berman projection, which is integral over D, same but without modulus, f of w, 1 minus z bar w squared dA of w. And still there are a lot of problems devoted to the study of this kind of projection, even in L2 space, in L2 case, even L2 case. So we may try to reformulate these problems in terms of the other type of operators, this type of operators, and try to solve these problems, but maybe it's for perspective for next papers and next conferences. Well, thank you very much, and happy birthday to Armen.